Okay, fine. It's not that convincing. I'm not Kimberly Wyatt. Right now, she's backstage preparing. But earlier on this week, I caught up with her and asked her a few questions that you guys had sent in. Check it out. Hello, Miss Kimberly Wyatt.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good.
Now, you've got a lot of fans on the internet, and they've been sending us in all manner of questions, which they're dying to ask you. So I thought it'd actually be really nice to just throw a few out of the bag.
Ask away.
Lauren wants to know, what is your favourite thing to do when you're not around all the paparazzi?
I'm a pretty simple girl, so I just love to stay in, cook great organic food. Well, I'm more of a sous chef, and someone else usually cooks it. But yeah, I like to read Paulo Coelho books. I love to write. That's really what I do in my free time.
You're a bit of a culture vulture, really, aren't you?
A little bit.
Wowee.
I know.
Emily asks, does Kimberly Wyatt still do ballet dancing, and does she always wear fashionable and stylish clothes? Kiss, 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 little kiss, heart.
That's so cute. I wish I could take more ballet. I've really kind of been engulfed in the music side with Her Majesty and the Wolves and making the album and whatnot. But yeah, I still try to get in class. I try to take as much as possible. And even getting ready for the Got to Dance performance has made me make time for that studio time, which I just love. I love getting lost in music. So
it's amazing that you still make time for things when you're so busy.
I know, it's not easy, but you know.
Have you got a really rigorous schedule? Is everything really outlined?
Yeah. It's really crazy right now, but it's amazing. I can't complain. Opportunity is wonderful.
Anita has asked, what would Kimberly's advice be for young girls who aspire to be like she is and wants to achieve something with their lives?
I always live by dream and believe. Anything is possible as long as you dream big and believe in yourself.
You're such an aspirational character, you know that. It's actually making me well up a little bit.
Is it?
Yeah.
A little tear.
Oh. Thanks, Kimberly.
You're welcome.
She touched me! And also our very own finalist has logged on and asked this question. I love the way that Kimberly recreates her look all the time, yada, yada, yada. Does she do this herself, or do people decide what she will look like, and how does she always manage to surprise us with a different look? Big kiss, little kiss.
Honestly, it's just kind of part of growing, and I seem to always change my hair when I reach a certain point in life. I don't know, I like to experiment with my look, and I always like to have fun, so as soon as I get bored, I'm always making change.
Well, that pretty much wraps up all the questions I'm going to ask you, because I want to know what we can expect from this week's performance.
I am truly so excited for this performance. I get to pull from my inspirations, and I've had time to design the costumes. This beautiful Vivian Westwood princess wedding dress I'm gonna dance in, and it's all Her Majesty and the Wolves music, and I've got the whole crew out.
You're doing the music as well?
Yeah.
No way. So absolutely. You're doing the music, the costumes, presumably you've kind of choreographed it, and you're dancing in it.
And I'm dancing in it. I love theater, and I love Tim Burton, and I've pulled from all my inspirations, and I just hope that it's a good performance that transcends to everyone watching. And it's just gonna be fun. I'm ready to just go out there and have a lot of fun.
Kimberly, you're truly an inspiration. Thank you so much for taking the time. Give me some skin. Oh, I didn't quite pull that off with as much streetwise vernacular as you did.
It's okay.
Take it easy. Oh, isn't she lovely? I still reckon there's a chance with her if I play my cards right. Realistically speaking, probably not so much. Anyway, make sure you join us from 6 p.m. for the last live semi-final.